With that nip in the air, the smell of pumpkin spice, and the rich color palettes of reds, oranges, and yellows filling our tree lines and grounds, it can only mean one thing, that autumn has finally arrived. Although you should probably go outside and enjoy it, I won't judge you if you'd rather stay in and experience the season with your Nintendo Switch. There's a hefty amount of Switch games on the system already, or coming soon to celebrate with. Here are 10 games I found that are suited to the fall season, and most of them you can play on your Switch right now, or running up to Halloween. I should warn you though that I have a huge bias toward Halloween when it comes to the season. Sorry, Thanksgiving and football, and most of the games on here favor that aspect of the season, but I'm not here to make a horror game list. No, these titles are more kitschy if anything, and vary in gameplay styles. So cozy up with a light sweater, grab something really heavy to snack on, and join us as we go over our top 10 autumn experiences that you can enjoy right now, or soon on your Nintendo Switch. Also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Night in the Woods is not only, in my opinion, one of the most underrated games on the Switch, but it's also the perfect companion game for you to play in the season of autumn. With this game releasing way too close to the release of Celeste back in January of 2018 on the Nintendo Switch, it's possible that you may have overlooked this one. No fear though, because with the leaves turning their autumn colors, now's the perfect time of the year to play it anyway. In this game, you play as a way too human cat in her 20s named Mae Bobrowski, who for reasons not explained in the game has returned home after dropping out of college. As she reacquaints herself with her hometown, you'll be introduced to a wonderful cast of animal buddies that may feel like your old pals in real life. And it's possible that you may even relate to someone in this cast if you're a 20 or 30 something. The protagonist of this game may, however, can be a little tough to watch at times as she interacts with the townspeople of Possum Springs. Mae is that friend that you may have or maybe even identify with a little bit that's maybe just a little immature and brutally honest. I mean, no filter between what she's thinking and what she's saying. And with limited dialogue options, you may find yourself cringing up a bit as Mae just makes a complete disaster out of situations. The real star in this game to me, however, is the town of Possum Springs, as it hits just a little too close to home for me. Possum Springs is a royal copper mining town that has been hit hard by an economic downturn as a result of a declining industry. You adventure through this town in the season of fall, which also seems like a metaphor in and of itself, as you navigate through what looks like it was once a blossoming town, now littered with vacant buildings that haunts the townspeople of memories of better times. Not gonna lie, when Mae reflects on her childhood hometown and how she used to go to the abandoned grocery store with her parents or have birthday dinners at the now closed restaurant Possibilities, I choked up a bit as I find this subject matter very relatable. There's a ton to do here also in A Night in the Woods as you wake up day to day in this 2D adventure style game. You participate in a myriad of activities through short mini games and basic exploration. And the variety is great, ranging from poking a dismembered arm with a stick or playing bass Guitar Hero style, or even grocery shopping. This game also takes place during one entire season, so expect to see some of your favorite fall traditions celebrated in this game. And there's a great story here to enjoy that autumn backdrop with, telling a tale of loss, change, and even a little supernatural stuff ripe for the season. I don't want to spoil any more of it for you, so just go ahead and download it from the eShop if you want to see more of what I'm talking about. Stardew Valley does a great job depicting all the seasons, but my favorite season of autumn is biasly depicted the best. Unless you've been living under a rock, I don't think I need to explain to you what this life slash farming simulator is, but just in case you have been, in short, it's a lot like Harvest Moon, but feels very distinct on its own. I recommend getting up early on the first day of fall and visiting Perry's General Store and stocking up on pumpkin seeds so you can grow your very own pumpkin patch. After growing your pumpkins, take a couple of them with you when you go to Pelican Town on the 16th for the Stardew Valley Fair. Show those guys off along with some of your other treasures you've crafted from your farm to win some star tokens. Festival season sure marks the coming of fall in my book, and the Stardew Valley Fair is a pretty good replication of that. The season ends in this game with this game's take on Halloween, Spirit's Eve. Go through a Halloween-themed maze and search for the golden pumpkin. No, it's no trick-or-treat, but it's festive enough to get the point across. Autumn is often referred to as the season of harvest, and if you're one of the few that hasn't already downloaded it already, then here's a great one to play this fall. Just be sure to clear a couple hundred hours off your calendar if you do, because warning, this one is addictive. If you travel northeast in Breath of the Wild's Hyrule, you'll be rewarded with the breathtaking landscapes of the Akala region. Rolling fields painted with reds, oranges, and yellows will greet you as you discover one of the most varied regions in the game. There's a sea to the east of you, a land sprinkled with ancient technology, a town you can build from the ground up, and in the region's most northern point, there's the seasons-appropriate Spooky Skull Island. There might not be a divine beast to tackle here, but that doesn't mean that there's not a great deal of activities to do while you're in the region. If you warp to the Akala Tower, you might want to go ahead and bundle up, as you'll notice it's just a tad bit chilly here. May I also suggest cooking up a feast worthy of the title Thanksgiving dinner while you're visiting? Pumpkin soup, anyone? Sure, you can build up Tarrytown by bombing the crap out of Mother Nature and harvesting her wood, or pay Robbie a visit to trade all those ancient parts you've been farming for tech ancient-related goods. But the real fun to be had here is following the quest line, A Shady Customer. If you'll have a chat with Haas, the guard at the East Akala Stables, he'll tell you about a mysterious fellow named Kilton. Few people have seen him, but have grown suspicious of his otherworldly activities. Haas even states that it makes the townspeople uncomfortable, as he panhandles around towns at night in a tent-based shop named Fang and Bones. Haas then asks if you see him to show him every detail of this creep, so you should head over to the Skull Lake where Kilton resides and see if you can sneak a picture. Once you do, prepare yourself for, well, a monster fanboy? Give him monster parts, get Halloween costumes. I actually like this guy a lot. One of my favorite pastimes during the month of fall is to just lay around and binge watch the crap out of horror movies. Up until recent years though, the icons of those movies have been absent from the video game scene for what feels like 20 years or more. Then along came Mortal Kombat to scoop some of those guys up and plop them into their fighting game. This was a fine way of utilizing characters like Freddy Krueger, but shouldn't these guys be out doing what they do best? You know, murdering the disassociated youth of the world? Well, now Jason has received his very own game, where Jason does what Jason does best, slashing and thrashing around Camp Crystal Lake, and his colleagues like Leatherface, Freddy Krueger, and Michael Myers can be found in a similar game by the name of Dead by Daylight. In both of these titles, you either play as one of the many stereotypical teenagers, aside from some guest characters such as a jock or a nerd, and try to work together to escape the night while you're being hunted down by one of these famed slashers. If you're lucky though, you might get to play as the villain and just wreak havoc on these teen players by murdering them. Yep, that's your goal. As to which one of these games you should invest your time and money into, I don't know how to answer that question for you. I guess if you're a huge Friday the 13th fan, then the answer is simple. Friday the 13th, the game, is built completely around that universe, and there's plenty to nerd out about if you're a fan of that series. You are more limited, however, by celebrating just that one franchise. With Dead by Daylight, there's a ton of variety as who's represented, and although they put a great effort into these guest characters appearing in this one, the game itself is made for multiple killers in mind. It's not as elaborate with the franchise as Friday the 13th was with Jason. Watch these guys or play with these guys. It's your decision. Who am I to tell you how to spend your Halloween season? Back in the 80s and 90s, finding a horror-inspired game was not the easiest thing to find. Games themed after horror icons like Jason, Freddy, and Leatherface had gained a reputation of being lower-quality games, so it was up to originally designed titles to fill the void if you wanted to play something worthwhile. The Castlevania series certainly filled a niche that was underserved at the time, and was rewarded for it by gaining a pretty big following that would run for the next 30 years after the incarnation of the original game. I do use the word horror loosely though, as the term hadn't quite defined itself in the realm of video games just yet at the time of its inception. The games featured in this year's Castlevania Anniversary Collection are by far not horror games in the sense that they evoke fear, but when Castlevania was finding its identity as a series, it paid homage to the early Universal monster movies, even going as far as to pay tribute in the credits of the first game. Of course, it really seemed to hone in on the gothicness of those films. Also, this is a Japanese interpretation of an American media that was mostly based off European folklore, which made for a very unique universe. With 8 games to pick from, there's never been a better time to jump into the series. Grab a bucket full of sugary candy and a pumpkin spice latte and marathon this one if you get the time this autumn. I'll try to keep this one brief, as I do intend to do a full review for this game on the channel. But for my taste anyway, I couldn't do a fall game list without including one of my favorite IPs of all time, Ghostbusters the Video Game. Has got it all if you're a fan of the film franchise. The music's here, the original cast has reprised their roles, making it feel like a third movie mixed with a video game, and a lot of the iconic locations from 1980s New York City are here for you to visit. The franchise's history with video games has been a bit rocky, with titles before and even after the original release of this game being mostly really bad. Don't let that spoil what could be a fantastic experience for you though, as this game is leaps and bounds better than any of the other offerings I mentioned. I know busting makes me feel good. How about you? I made a list back in the summer very similar to this one, but of course it was a summer-themed list, and Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze was on that list. Spoilers for future list, if I make a list in the same vein, it'll probably be on there too. I'm gonna do this because Retro Studios crafted such a wonderful world in this game that seems to have taken inspiration from all of the seasons. In past Donkey Kong Country games, the ape has been spotted in tropical jungles, of course, and even scaled snowy mountaintops. But with this game though, Autumn has made its debut in World 2 in the form of Autumn Heights. Autumn Heights is a mountain island in the shape of an owl, with red, yellow, and pine trees running all the way up to the top of it. And as you scale the mountain, your eyes will be treated to some of the finest fall decor that any video game has ever offered. Mountain Mania will start you off right in the middle of a pumpkin patch, and Horntop Hop will have you platforming on leaves gently falling to the ground. Also, you'll be treated to a soundtrack by David Wise that fits that uniquely crafted world perfectly. Take your time with this one though, as I don't think a game has ever paid tribute to the season this well since Banjo-Kazooie's Click Clock Wood level, and it'll probably be a long time before someone crafts one again. You're probably thinking that I would include a Resident Evil game on this list because of its identity as a horror game, right? Nope. I'm including Resident Evil 4 on my list because of the unnamed town tucked away in Royal Spain, simply known as The Village. Like the film of the same name, this location is a cut-off community that is centuries behind when it comes to modern technology. This isn't no stroll in the park, however, as the villagers are far from friendly, and if you're not paying attention to your surrounding, the leaves do a great job masking booby traps like tripwires. Amongst all the chaos though, if you slow down after you've cleared some of the enemies, the village can be quaint and beautiful to take in. This is all in the first chapter of the game, and it makes for the perfect setting to build the lore up for this title. If you've ever traveled to the countryside to maybe a state-run park for the season to take in some of the views, I know you're bound to have ran into some of these preserved areas that looked very similar to this village. Definitely go out and do that if you have the time to do so this autumn, as the season seems so short at its peak. But if for some reason you missed it, playing Resident Evil 4 is an okay substitute. But just make sure to watch out for those axe-wielding crazies. Oh man, if Nintendo ever created a game with Disney's Haunted Mansion in mind, it would have to be 2001's Luigi's Mansion. And now we live in a world where this once-thought, one-off game is now a series. It's only taken 18 years for this franchise to return to a home console. But if you're a Nintendo Switch owner, you'll finally be treated to the next installment in this series. How do you top a mansion full of ghouls? We'll make it an entire hotel, of course. In this game, it looks like Luigi will be armed with the poltergeist G-O-O and a goopy buddy named Gooigi as he tackles floor after floor of ghastly baddies. So far, we've seen floors themed after cinema, medieval times, pirates, Egyptian tombs, and even a disco hall. I'm mostly excited about the portrait ghost making a return in this one though, and with different themed floors, who knows what types of ghosts you'll be sucking up this time around. Poor Luigi normally has to go at this ghost busting business alone, but not this time. Not only can a friend grab a second controller and join you as Gooigi, but there's also a multiplayer mode to enjoy this time around. Scarescraper makes its return from Dark Moon, which is a mode where you and your friends can compete online to take on randomly generated generated floors to see who can suck up the most ghosts. But Nintendo's also offering a local multiplayer mode that allows you, with up to 8 other people this time around, to compete in mini-games in a mode called Scream Park. You'll be seeing who can suck up the most ghosts or collect the most coins. If you're a Nintendo fan, there's not gonna be a better way to spend Halloween other than picking up this one when it launches on that day. Okay, I said I was gonna steer away from straight-up nightmare-inducing horror games with this list, and I think I've done a pretty good job at keeping that promise so far. RE4 is an action game at its core, although it certainly has its moments, and Friday the 13th and Dead by Daylight are horror-themed online multiplayer games that are a lot more fun than they are scary. I'm gonna stick to that promise though, because Yoshi's Crafted World is not a horror game. In fact, it's one of the cutest games you can pick up on the platform at the time. There is a level in this game, however, that's just such a stark contrast to the rest of the game, though, that it had to make the number one spot on my list. I'm not talking about the Haunted Maker Mansion, which is a great level that gave me some Castlevania vibes. No, if you played this one, then you know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the late game level that resides in the Shadowville area. Be Afraid of the Dark. No, not Don't Be Afraid of the Dark, but Be Afraid. Let's just strip away all the comfort before we even dive into this one. This is the closest Nintendo has ever come to creating their own .exe creepypasta-style level, after being rewarded with some space theme levels and a ride down a river of absolute bliss. This level comes at you and rips all those fuzzy warm feelings away that the game has fed you that led to this moment. If you thought Be Afraid of the Dark was just a pun on the words to maybe introduce you to some light and dark mechanic, then yeah, you would be right, it is. It's what's lurking in the dark that really raises the hair on the back of your neck though. Coulrophobia is defined as an irrational fear of clowns, and yeah, this level has them. I don't know what you call the fear of killer axe-wielding clowns though, but I'm pretty sure I do have that. Even the hitboxes are there to feed your fear. If you hit the first one you spot in this level, it informs you that if he sees you, run away, and you should probably listen. Another one will inform you that he'll come from behind, in which after you release the chat box, there he is. One thing this level does teach you though, is that there's comfort in the light. Even if the gut-curling screams one of these clowns lit off, if it touches the light is absolutely terrifying. So how do you win the level? Well, the light that you run into for safety burns out, leaving you to hightail it out of there as you outrun legions of these things to the goal. Well, that's gonna do it for me. What games are you gonna be playing this fall? Be sure to tell us in the comment section below. And if you haven't already done so already, please give this video a like and subscribe to the channel, as we would really appreciate it. And for more on autumn games, stay tuned to the Weekend Moblin.